Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Mad About Cards and Crafts. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am featuring a distress oxide ink blending technique. I'm going to be getting really inky today, adding lots of layered distress oxide ink to get texture and interest on my die cut pieces. I'm using from Lawn Fawn this brick stencil, and from Tim Holtz, the Stripes stencil. This is going to add texture to our background. I started off my card with this ink to paper Frame It Out Wishes. I'm using the die cut for the smile, both the shadow die and the word die, as well as a sentiment. From the Greetery, Macramade For You and Macramade For You Fillers. And then this is a die set that I purchased from Anna Griffin. I will link all the products I used in the description box below. You get 4 different die sets with this collection, and you also get a card-based die. I have not used the card-based die yet. I create my own card bases. In fact, today's card base is Nina Desert Storm. I cut it to 7 by 8.5, and then I scored it at the 7-inch mark at 3.5 inches to get a 3.5 by 8.5 inch card base. But you certainly could use this die right here that I'm sharing with you. I believe it cuts out a 4 by 9 slimline card. These are beautiful dies, a great bargain. I don't receive any commission from this particular set, but I will list it in the description box below. I have a piece of Canson XL watercolor paper. You don't need very expensive watercolor paper for this technique, but I do prefer to use watercolor paper. And I'm just doing a little bit of ink smooshing right there. The colors that I used were Evergreen Bough, Peacock Feathers, and Mermaid Lagoon. I'm gonna dry in between. My paper was dry. I just added water to my Distress Oxide ink, and now I'm adding a little bit more Mermaid Lagoon. You can see that I'm doing some swiping here. I'm gonna add some Mowed Lawn to get a little bit more vibrancy to this piece. Dry it, and then I'm going to bring in my shadow die for the word smile, and I will cut this out using that shadow die. So I didn't cut a very big piece of cardstock because I knew I was going to just be using it for my sentiment. And then you'll see when I start creating my other pieces, I just cut my panels, you know, that I'm going to be inking to the size of the dies that I'll be using. So here is that compendium die. This is the larger one that I'm using. I think it's the second largest die, and I'm going to do a little bit of ink blending using Peacock Feathers and a brush that I have that's very similar to the Altenew brush. I got these on Amazon. So I love these large brushes for larger spaces, and I'm gonna just do the ink blending all the way around the edges. Once I get it the way that I want it, I'm gonna come in with some of that Mowed Lawn, and I'm just going to add it here and there around the edges. The edge part of the die cut is all that's gonna be showing, since this is a layering piece, and I don't need to waste all the ink going all the way into the center. Once I get this Mowed Lawn down, I'm going to come in again with the Peacock Feathers and blend over that, and that will be my base layer. Next, I'm coming with the top layer, and I'm using the Mermaid Lagoon. I'm going to ink up this panel, so this is the third from the largest die. And I'm gonna ink all the way around that. I'm gonna bring the Mowed Lawn in again. I'm going to use one of my blending brushes and add that all around the edges. As you can see, I'm still not going into the center of this. Most of the center should be covered with my die cut pieces. You can see to the right that ink to paper vine. As I said, that was the initial direction that I thought, the original direction I thought I was gonna go in. And I just changed my mind midstream. Here I'm adding some water to my project. I did just pump the handle halfway so I got those bigger droplets. I have cut the word smile using some Festive Lights paper from Tonic Studio. It's a flat gold color, and I did put the tittle in a tray. I tend to lose my tittles. I don't know about you, but I lose mine frequently, so I put it in a tray so that I wouldn't lose it. It's so incredibly small, and I'm using my jewel picker just to pick it up and add it to my die cut piece. Let's start working on our terracotta. You're going to see an amazing transformation. So I start with the wild honey, which was the yellowish color, and then I also use crackling campfire and rusty hinge, and I'm swiping again. So I really like that swiping motion for texture. I will start dabbing as well to get the dots, because you know there's going to be movement and variation in color in a terracotta pot. So I'm just building on this. I'm adding more color. And again, I clean up in between. That's something that's very important. Make sure that you clean up in between, because if you want to add another color, just one color, which is where I start going, then you're going to want to make sure that you're not muddying up that ink. So I added some more crackling campfire. I wanted a little bit more of a red tint to this. And I'll come back in with the rusty hinge to kind of dull it down a little bit. I was feeling like it was just still a little bit too vibrant. There's lots of texture. It looks very ugly right now. Like, how in the world is this going to be a terracotta pot? But I will take my die, go over and cut it out, and then I'm going to bring in some of the magic colors. I'm starting with tea dye, so I'm adding that tea dye all the way over the entire image. I'm adding vintage photo around the edges. And so now you can see that terracotta feel is starting to come to life. I did cut out the two macrame hangers from the same Nina Desert Storm cardstock. I'm going to add a little bit of color. I had some vintage photo left on my brush, and I added that vintage photo. I didn't re-ink it. I just added what was on my brush. And now I wanted a little bit more orange, so I'm adding some ripe persimmon, which you're going to see is going to add a little bit more vibrancy to this, but we're going to tone that down again. And now I have brushed corduroy, so I'm adding a little bit of brushed corduroy to my macrame hangers. And then I'm adding it to my terracotta pot, and this is really going to tone things down. I did dry it in between. And I'm going to set those aside, and we're going to work on another strip of Canson paper, and we're going to work on the greenery. So I am using the Rustic Wilderness and Crushed Olive. And you see I didn't get very much coverage there. So I'm going to do it again. And there I brought in a little bit of scattered straw. I wanted to add some yellow to the tone, so there's scattered straw that I just put down. And here I'm adding some green. So I think that was a little bit of mowed lawn. And then I'm going to add the Rustic Wilderness again. And you see, I'm just getting those layers. I'm going to show you a close-up of my card at the end, and you're going to get a really good look at the texture that I was able to get just by doing this ink smushing and swiping. And again, I'm drawing in between each of the layers, because with Distress Oxide, that's one of the nice properties, is that you can layer on top of each other. I wanted to add some texture, and this texture doesn't show up all that great in the photos, but it is there. I'm using some Unicorn White pigment ink and the Tim Holtz stripe stencil, and I'm just adding some random stripes down my card, and that is the top layer right there. And then I'm going to take the brick stencil and some vintage photo, and I'm going to randomly add some ink to this stencil so that I get some of that brick in the background. I didn't want a solid bit of brick, but I did want to make sure that I added that texture to the back of the card to give it the look of a wall. These are my Gonzai Tombi Starry metallic watercolors, and I have put some water in there, and I'm using that gold that you can see, and I'm just tapping on some color. There's a little embossed edge on these die cuts, and so I decided that I wanted to add just a little bit of gold. I thought about doing perfect pearls, and then I thought, you know, I already have this out, let's just use this. And I love the feel of this. I love that tiny little texture of gold around the edges. I do mess up one of the spots, my paintbrush is going to slip and I'm going to get a little bit of a swipe, but that's okay. I just think that that added gold really made a difference in the card. I could have done a tearing at the top of this and folded it over a little bit. That would have been a pretty piece of texture to add to this, but instead I decided just to go with the full panel. As you can see, I did forget to hit record, and I did put my potted plants together. So I glued the plants inside of the pots, and then I added that macrame piece over the top. I wanted this one to appear as it was hanging, so I wanted to make sure that the thread showed. So this is just some twine or thread from my stash. And I'm placing my elements where I want them, and I'm gluing them directly down to my card panel. And then I'll do a little bit of trimming. So I wanted to make sure that one was a little bit higher than the other. And then I'm going to add that plant at the bottom. I decided not to put all three on hangers. I thought it was nice to have one sitting on the floor. I like the trifecta of having the three elements on my card. So I did decide to stick with the three potted plants. I'm gluing down my twine, and then we're going to stamp our sentiment. So the sentiment is again from the Ink to Paper Frame It Out Wishes set. I'm going to use Vintage Photo Distress Oxide ink. The Distress Oxide ink does stamp nicely in my Misti, so no worries about that. I placed the sentiment smile where I thought I was going to want it when I glued it down, and then I put my other sentiment underneath it. I think it says my dearest friend underneath it, and did the stamping. Now we can add that word smile. I am going to add some foam adhesive to the back. I did cut that part out, but I did add foam adhesive to the back of this layer right here. And I did take my brick stencil, and in that right corner, because I was laying that potted plant over the other stenciling, I felt like I needed to add that brick. I think I should have stamped off or brushed off my brush, because I did get it a little bit darker than I wanted it, but that's okay. It still worked. And then I'm gluing my panel down to this Nina Desert Storm cardstock. I'm using my Dove blender pen because I wanted to really put some shading underneath the lip of the terracotta pots. I wanted to make sure that there was some dimension there, and using your Dove blender pen is a great way to use the same colors. So I started with the brush corduroy, and then I added a little bit of vintage photo to get that depth. I recut the images using the same paper that I colored the plants from initially, and I cut a second set, and now I'm cutting them to put in front of that macrame. I'm not gluing these ones all the way down, so the first pieces you saw I glued down to that card panel, and this one I'm leaving it loose. So I'll show you at the very end, once I get all of this down, I'll show you the movement on those pieces. I love that. I love not gluing everything down so that there's dimension without putting dimension tape dimensional tape behind it. It just adds a little bit more flow and a little bit more interest. And that's going to be my card for today. I really hope that you enjoyed this process, that you'll give this ink layering a try. Here's a look at that card, the gold splatters, the white pigment ink, all of the texture that I was able to get in my die cuts. Thanks so much for watching. I hope that you have a fabulous day, and I hope to see you back here soon.